بيك خلقك الحمد لله ما حد.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته, and a very 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 warm أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا بكم to this part of the community showcase program hosted by ITV and coming to you from our Cape Town studios based here in Lansdowne. My name is Taj Aklika. It's a privilege to be your anchor for this part of the show. And today we're profiling a beautifully, an illustrious organization, one with incredibly noble ideals, and that is none other than Fajrul Islam, the center of Fajrul Islam based in Athlone. With me in the studios, I'm privileged and honored to have its leadership and none other than Sheikh Sulaiman Salama with me, and Sheikh, ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. It's nice to have Sheikh in the studio.
Ahlan wa sahlan, shukran wa jazakum Allah khairan.
The organization, according to the internet, started in 2009, but I understand that it had beginnings way before then. Just a little bit of a brief overview on the establishment of the organization, how it started, what was the purpose of it coming into existence, please, for the purposes of our viewers.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Fajr al-Islam Center is a community-based organization. That means it doesn't belong to any individuals. It's open for every person. He's welcome to be part of that organization. And the idea came to establish this organization of Fajr al-Islam when we find the environment of South Africa is the best environment right through the world for Islam and Muslims. So where there is no any sensitivity when you speak to a non-Muslim about Islam, like not other countries, they have too much problems. So I always say this is a golden opportunity for Islam and Muslims of South Africa to make use of that environment, that healthy environment, to spread Islam and to introduce Islam to many people in a country, those who have no idea about Islam at all. So Fajr Islam start a long time before the year 2009, but the only registration with the government came on 2009 as officially registered organization under section 21 as non-profit organization. And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the success to get our tax exemption certificate as a non-profit organization. They call it PBO, public benefit organization. So, and the name of Fajr al-Islam is not just by accident. The name of Fajr al-Islam came from the methodology of da'wah that we use when we introduce Islam to people. In the early age, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to go from door to door, knock by people's house, introduce Islam to the people individually. So Fajr al-Islam is dawn of Islam. So we're following the early age of the methodology of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam when he introduced Islam to people. So we knock by people's doors, we ask them permission if we can talk to them, explain to them Islam. They welcome us sometimes they refuse. So this is Fajr Islam, means we start from the early method of introducing and spreading Islam in a community. And Fajr Islam start in one of the new Muslims' house. This new Muslim, he allows us, we don't have space, we don't have any, a place to start. So we asked man permission if we can use his house for as a school for us. He's got a big room, so we used to have it for classes. And alhamdulillah, this man, he doesn't have children, he's got only him and his wife. So this man, finally, he donated his house to Fajr al-Islam. I asked him, why you want to give your house? He said, no, I am the me and my wife don't have children. So I want this house to stand for me till the day of judgment for waqf, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The man passed away after the house being registered on Fajr al-Islam's name, about 1 week after the house was transferred to Fajr al-Islam's name. So alhamdulillah, we start from there. It was the start, the spark start for Fajr al-Islam. Alhamdulillah, nowadays Fajr al-Islam runs more than three branches plus the head office that is operating from 8 o'clock till after Maghrib. We run it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We introduce Islam and we teach people the proper way. So our methodology, not only to give the people kalima shahada, but we also follow up with them and we teach them the principle, the moderate Islam, not extremist and not too lenient. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. You are from the average of the ummah, average in akhlaq, average in attitude and everything. So this is our methodology where we start. We start Fajr Islam at one of the new Muslim, a new revert's house. And alhamdulillah, up to now, Fajr Islam spread. And is the last branch is going to start, inshallah, in January at Montague Springs, which is about 200 kilo far from Cape Town.
Sheikh, that is absolutely marvelous. That's doing exceptional work. Your Montague program as part of an outreach program outside the city of Cape Town.
Yes.
Just can just give us a bit of a sense of, I'm excited about this, just a sense of how that particular program is going to unfold quickly.
Alhamdulillah, we are not only operating our centers. In a rural area, we also we run programs, dawah programs, where we take medical doctors with us, with the cooperation with Muslim Doctor Association. May Allah bless them and grant them a reward. We run a da'wah program. We announce, we distribute flyers in the area. We say this program is going to take place on that day, on that area. And so give the people the right information. When they come, we accommodate them in one tent while they are waiting to see doctor. We introduce to them Islam, we give them booklets, we give them some information about Islam. And in one program only, about 100 people, more than 100 people, believe me, they came to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was in Montague Springs. Montague Springs, the idea how we reach Montague Springs is not our decision to go there. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's plan. One lady phoned me one day, said, I want to embrace Islam. So I said, okay, come to the office. You know where the office, I give her the direction how to come to office. When she came to the office, she's supposed to be 11 o'clock. She came 2:30. Then I asked her, why are you late? I'm waiting for you from morning. She told me, if you know from where I come, you'll excuse me. Say, from where? Said, from Montague Springs. So this was first time to hear the word Montague Springs. Then I ask her, where is it? She's about 200 kilo from far from Cape Town. Believe me, wallah, I felt very shy. Well, the lady came all the way, and this is our job. So I told her, can we run some programs? Is there any masjid in your area? She said, no masjid at all. Is there any, said, even there's no church. In a locality next to Montague Springs, they call it Ashbury. So we give her some flyers to distribute to the people. Can we run some programs in He said, no problem. So we hired a community hall there in the inner town. We accommodate people. We got about 150 people on that day. So from there, we start to run regular programs in Montague Springs, though we don't have facility to start to teaching. But we run it from like twice a year, three times a year. We go visit for da'wah program, also arrange such program with them. So we keep in touch with them. But alhamdulillah now, we got the ground from the council through a tender. It's registered on Fajr al-Islam's name. We're going to put for them, inshallah, a complete center.
Sheikh, I'm totally excited. We're just going to go for a quick ad break. Viewers, there you have it, Fajr al-Islam, the great work that they're doing. So please don't go away. We're just going for a very short ad break, and then we'll rejoin you. Shukran jazilan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Don't go away. We'll be back shortly.
Dreams in the kiss of